And if we have learned anything from history, it is that power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. This is Aaron Russo, a filmmaker and former politician. To his left is Nicholas Rockefeller of the infamous Rockefeller Banking and Business Dynasty. After maintaining a close friendship with Nicholas Rockefeller, Aaron eventually ended the relationship, appalled by what he had learned about the Rockefellers and their ambitions.
I got a call one day from an attorney woman I knew, and she said, "Would you like to meet one of the Rockefellers?" I said, "Sure, I'd love to." And we became friends, and he began to divulge a lot of things to me. So he said to me one night, he said that there's going to be an event there, and out of that event, you're going to see we're going to go into Afghanistan, so we can run pipelines from the Caspian Sea. We're going to go into Iraq to take the oil and establish a base in the Middle East, and we're going to go into Venezuela and try and get rid of Chavez. And the first two they've accomplished, Chavez they didn't accomplish. And he said, you're going to see guys going into caves looking for looking for people that they're never going to find. You know, he was laughing about the fact that you have this war on terror. There's no real enemy. He's talking about how by having this war on terror, you can never win it because it's an eternal war. And so you can always keep taking people's liberties away. And I said, how are you going to convince people that this war is real? He said, but the media. The media can convince everybody it's real. I mean, you know, it's just that you keep talking about things. You keep saying it over and over and over again, and eventually people believe it. You know, you created the Federal Reserve in 1913 through lies. You create 9/11, which is another lie. Through 9/11, you're fighting a war on terror, and now all of a sudden you go into Iraq, which was another lie, and now they're going to do Iran. You know, and it's all one thing leading to another, leading to another, leading to another. Now, I would say to him, what are you doing this for? What's the point of this thing? You have all the money in the world you ever want. You have all the power. I said, you know, you're hurting people. It's not a good thing. And he would say, what do you care about the people for? Take care of yourself and take care of your family. And then I said to him, what are the ultimate goals here? He said, the ultimate goal is to get everybody in this world chipped with the chip, with the RFID chip, and have all money be on those chips and everything on those chips. And if anybody wants to protest what we do or violate what we want, we just turn off their chip.
That's right, microchipped. In 2005, Congress, under the pretense of immigration control and the so-called war on terrorism, passed the REAL ID Act, under which it is projected by May 2008, you will be required to carry around a federal identification card, which includes on it a scannable barcode with your personal information. However, this barcode is only an intermediary step before the card is equipped with a VeriChip RFID tracking module, which will use radio frequencies to track your every move on the planet. If this sounds foreign to you, please note that the RFID tracking chip is already in all new American passports. And the final step is the implanted chip, which many people have already been manipulated into accepting under different pretenses.
We have a Florida family who are really pioneers in a brave new world. They have volunteered to be the first ever to have microchip identification devices implanted into their bodies.
After 9/11, I was really concerned with the security of my family.
I wouldn't mind having something planted permanently in my arm that would identify me.
In the end, everybody will be locked into a monitored control grid where every single action you perform is documented. And if you get out of line, they can just turn off your chip, for at that point in time, every single aspect of society will revolve around interactions with the chips. This is the picture that is painted for the future if you open your eyes to see it. A centralized one-world economy where everyone's moves and everyone's transactions are tracked and monitored, all rights removed. The most incredible aspect of all. These totalitarian elements will not be forced upon the people. The people will demand them. For the social manipulation of society through the generation of fear and division has completely detached humans from their sense of power and reality. A process which has been going on for centuries, if not millennia. Religion, patriotism, race, wealth, class, and every other form of arbitrary, separatist identification, and thus conceit, has served to create a controlled population, utterly malleable in the hands of the few. Divide and conquer is the motto, And as long as people continue to see themselves as separate from everything else, they lend themselves to being completely enslaved.